Today on Toy Shiz, there's something strange in the neighborhood. Who you gonna call? No, not He-Man. Welcome back, everyone. Toy Shiz here, and I am back getting in to give you guys another fresh look courtesy of my friends over at Hasbro, and I am freaking stoked on this. Ghostbusters, the real Ghostbusters, are back. Sure, we knew these were coming, but they are nice enough. They sent over some early samples of their Wave 2 of the Kenner Classics that are exclusive to Walmarts. I know, I hear the groans already. But hey, you know what? Hopefully, much like the first round, once they kind of got circulated in the stores, they were pretty easy to find, and they still are to this day. But we'll start it off with some fearsome flesh action. Again, Harry Moore design, killing it on the card art recreation. Did the same thing with Spider-Man, the animated series. The Fearsome Flesh Ghost is just one of those toys, figures, that when you think of the real Ghostbusters toy line back in the day, the toilet is on the top, right? There's lots of different ghosts that they came out with. Each of them have their own nostalgic purposes, of course. But, you know, anytime you give me a toilet that turns into a monster, that's the toilet that I want. Here's the barcode if you're gonna need it. And then also, the Bug Eye Ghost, which was another great one. Very cool artwork on this. I love the purples. Very simplistic card art. Remember this stuff? Wasn't a whole lot to it. You had a really nice illustration of the toy you were buying on the backside. Shows you everything that it entails, the cross sells, how it works. I'm going to karate chop the heck out of this because I can't do that with my old Kenner ones anymore. And here's the barcode for the Bug Eye Ghost as well. And then finally, we're going to be checking out the brand new reissue of the Ecto-1. As if I didn't have enough Ecto-1s, right? I'll also get out the Extreme Ghostbusters, Ecto-2, all that kind of stuff, including my original Ecto-1. But look at the artwork on this. Egon, Winston, Peter, you got the little Ecto-1 ghost right there in the claw. This makes me happy, even though, I mean, I've had these for years and years and years. And yeah, it's fun to have real Ghostbusters back on the shelf, so don't take this away from me. Just sit back and enjoy it. You already know how this video is gonna go. So this will be more in terms of really comparing them. You do get to see the various differences from the old Ecto-1. GM now has a sticker on this, official GM merchandise, and here's the barcode as well. So just to reiterate, these are real Ghostbuster figures. I love the real Ghostbuster figures. I got all the toys, so we're gonna look at the old ones. So here's my old Fearsome Flesh, my old Bug Eye Ghost, and we'll pull out everything, all a whole enchilada, all that kind of stuff. This is going to be fun. Sit back, relax, grab yourself a nice hot cup of ectoplasm. That's something they should re-release too. Ectoplasm. We need ectoplasm. That would be awesome. This is a look at the brand new Hasbro / Kenner, right? Reboot, reissues, the real Ghostbusters Wave 2 featuring Fearsome Flesh, the Bug Eye Ghost, and the original Ecto-1. And here's the two ghosts with the most out of the packaging, and they are very different to what came before with the original Kenners. So just right off the bat, I will tell you this. If you're thinking you're going to get confused with the last ones, no. And I'm going to show you why. The first one we'll start with is the Bug-Eyed Ghost, and he looks great. Fantastic recreation. Every nook, every cranny, every little detail, down to just the weird bumps and bruises all over him. They nailed it. So very cool on that. He even has the demonic face on his back. Eyes, nose, mouth. It's still there. So I'm really glad that they kept that. But yeah, like I said, the sculpted details, the veins, the hands, the fingernails, the eyes, nose, mouth, the giant eye, right? I'll show you that in just a second. But still pops out. Nice, vibrant green string attaches somewhere in his head cavity right there, which is great to see. It's all a little bit different, I'll tell you what, because it's seeing it now with the old Kenner one, you can definitely see the differences. Color aside, the eyeball is now huge. Look at the old one compared to this new one. So the sculpt is there, but yeah, they've kind of tweaked it a little bit, and it totally makes it a different looking figure. So that is cool. And yeah, the eyeballs are, you know, doesn't even compare. One is humongous, the old one very tiny, but the pattern, the colors, everything else for the most part is still spot on. The string, though, is a lot shorter this time around compared to the old Kenner one. And I'm sure that has to do with child safety and everything. Kids aren't going to be strangling themselves with this new Ghostbusters. The old one, maybe. But yeah, you can see it's almost, I would say, a little bit more. It's maybe double the size of the new string on the old one. So that's cool to see. And then plus, the eye cavity, you can see how they have changed that a lot more wide on the new one, whereas the old one, you know, just a lot more compact. The bottom is generally the same, just different markings now, 2021. That's really different, so you're really not going to get confused anytime soon on which one's the old one and which one's the new one. And now here comes the real test, right? We're going to pop the eyeball. Can't do it on the old one anymore. He's just become old, hard plastic, brittle. He's starting to crack here and there. If I was to smash this guy down, yeah, he would break into a million pieces. But not with this new one, right? Fingers crossed. Because he's so squishy. Look at that brand new plastic right there. Oh, man. I am going to have some fun. And hopefully, yeah, it does exactly what it says it's going to do. Is going to hit Egon and Louis Tully. 1, 2, 3, and boom! No! Again! No. Oh, man. We failed. All right. Can't recommend these. Gonna have to just call it a wash. No more. Let's get this guy reloaded. We're gonna try this again. God, how embarrassing, right? All right, let's try this. We're gonna do full fist this time. 1, 2, 3, and there we go! Yeah! Home run, baby! Ghostbusters are down. Now that's some classic bug-eyed ghost action right there. And of course, next up, we have just a ordinary, everyday toilet. There's nothing weird about it, nothing haunted about it, of course. Just has the Ghostbusters logo on there. You simply just sit on it, use it like a regular toilet. Nothing spooky about this one, as you can see, right? It's very much a new Fearsome Flush, I will say that. Different coloring, we'll get to that in just a second. But of course, the real magic happens when you roll him along and he comes to life. God, that is so cool. And I'm really glad that Hasbro recreated that so well. I'm glad they didn't do it to where, you know, new toys are, they cut corners here and there. To compare it with the old one, as you can see, the colors are different, right? And this one has treads on the bottom, whereas the old one does not. So you can really roll the new one anywhere, but as you can see, the bottom is very different. You can see the guts of the old one, where now they put a plastic piece in this. And yeah, you can see the gears, how it all works. The little piece at the back of the toilet is a little bit different. So it's very much a different figure, much like the bug-eyed ghost. So you're really not going to be confusing the two anytime soon. So nice subtle changes. I like it. Whereas I have to use a very porous material, you know, to kind of get my old Fearsome Flush opening his mouth and such. So yeah, the new one though, it's hard to keep open. I will say that. I don't know if it's the old toy and it just doesn't work as well, you know, like kind of shake them to see if they work. But yeah, the old one stays open. The new one likes to close. I'm just going to keep my finger right there, keep the thing. But the tongue is pretty much the same. The underside, little purple goo ectoplasm thing is the same. The teeth are a little bit different in the sense of just the paint itself. Plus, you can see into the bowl on the old one, whereas the new one, it's like a full-on toilet bowl this time around. So, again, very cool to have this new one. Very cool to see the changes, to see how they've updated it. But you're not going to get these confused anytime soon, and it really is a new Fearsome Flush. I really dig it. I love the way the mouth opens and closes. I like they put treads. It's a nice upgrade. This is a definite nice upgrade to the old one. But you know what? The old one, still classic. Look at that. I love the tongue action right there. And just to coincide with the old commercial, of course, you got the Wolfman monster. Even he can't tell the difference, right? Old one, new one. They ever get to the point where they remake these monsters, which I guess I wouldn't mind. Yeah, it would be nice. Go crazy with real Ghostbusters. That's what I'm trying to say. Love these things. And then finally, we have our look at the brand new reissue of the Ecto-1. And look how crisp, look how white that is. My Ecto-1 has looked like this since day one. But man, oh man, it is so cool to have Ecto-1 back. Just, in this type of condition. Sure, yeah, it's a reissue, but man, oh man, the colors are popping. There's no broken parts. There's no gashes. There's no ripped stickers. There's nothing. It's just pure real Ghostbusters right there. Factory fresh. Oh man, it looks fantastic. The windshields are great. The battle chair, whatever you want to call this thing, the chair that confused kids because it wasn't in the cartoon sort of thing, but it was in some artwork here and there. But yeah, this is cool. It's a little bit different in terms of the heftiness and the plastic, but for the most part, it's pretty much the exact same. Same texture, same seatbelt, same ray gun things on the side, everything else. So I'll compare it in just a few with my old one. But yeah, pretty much the same exact thing, which is nice to see, of course. You get the same ghost, right? The Ecto-1 orange ghost. He looks good. Very see-through plastic. And you'll notice the changes when I show it just a few. But the Ecto-1 itself is, again, so crisp, so clean. And it sounds like the Ecto-1. It has the ricketiness of the tires, the wheel wells, everything. All the details are there. The blue plastic for the windshield, the front, the dashboard. You can see inside. Nothing has really changed all that much on this. They've pretty much recreated it. Down to the underside of the carriage, everything, all the details within, even the little capture claw, the wheels. It's really, really cool. I'll show you how the capture claw works and everything if you've never seen that before. But yeah, you can move the exhaust. You can see that it's the same exact function for the capture claw. You can pull the trunk latch down. You can see inside the bed right there. And you can pull this cord out. You can open it up to capture the ghost, of course, you know, because that's how you do it. Not a ghost trap or anything, it's just a capture claw. Why not? Different string on this one, too. This one's a lot thicker. And then you have the doors that still open, swing open, they catch right there. It's so new. That's the best part. Seat is great. All looks cool inside. If you don't have an Ecto-1, if you're looking to get a new one, you're going to be very, very happy with this. There's hardly any noticeable huge changes to this. It's like you're back in the 80s buying it all over again. That's something we do a lot, right? But in this sense, Ghostbusters will let it slide. The colors are bright. Again, there's no gashes on the windshield. If only it had electronics, that would be cool, right? But in terms of the battle chair right here, it simply fits a lot more snug this time around. It really sits in there, probably because mine's just loose over the years. But yeah, you really kind of have to move it in order to get it going. Same thing with the red weapons on the sides. You really got to move them to get them going. Now, one thing is, it comes with the instruction booklet, of course. You got the Ecto-1, you get the really cool line artwork, very reminiscent of Kenner. It just doesn't have the Kenner catalogs and stuff. Those came later, but, you know, it shows you all the how the stickers are applied, how the chair can fit in there every which way, and just largely how everything works. But yeah, see this fold down the middle? It got caught in the box, which the stickers are also inside, so it's kind of a bummer because it folded the stickers right in the back window sticker. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wait to put these on, hopefully get them flattened out again. But now it makes it easier to kind of see the difference between each one, even though, I mean, one's yellow, one's pristine white. But here's my old Ecto-1. One of several Ecto-1s, we'll just say. But this is the one that I've had since I was a little kid. And it's still great. Brings back all the memories. Very noticeable differences, of course. I would say the one difference between these two is that the new Ecto-1 seems to be just a tad bit shorter in the length and then in the height, but everything else is largely the same. And you might see other differences here and there, but yeah, that's what really stands out to me. But all the details is there. Nothing that's like the ghosts, you know, very, very much different, except for maybe the capture claw string. But as you can see, yeah, the chairs, largely the same, just a little bit lighter, has different gears on it, of course. And then the little knob right there is a little bit wider on the new one. So that's really the only noticeable differences. And again, plus mine is all beat to heck. But hey, at least I have it, right? Same thing with the ghosts. Not much difference other than the plastic maybe used. The plastic is a lot more clear on the new one, whereas the old one, yeah, a little bit more solid, and he has different texture on the feet, whereas it has ridges on the side where it's more of a flat bottom on the old one. But yeah, face is there, the colors are there. Yeah, it's pretty much the same exact ghosty and still on the same on the bottom of the Ecto-1. Minus mine is missing the capture claw. Hey, you know what? It's what happens when you throw this thing down a hill and you think you're gonna haul a tree branch with it. Don't worry about it. It's somewhere lost in the 80s. But yeah, the trunk, it's all there. It works. You can slide this thing in there and it all works. And yeah, same thing on the new one. Put these down a little bit. And yeah, it's really nice to see just the recreation of the old one. Trunk latches up. This one, trunk latches up. Very cool. Now, the big question is, will the old Ghostbusters fit inside this new Ecto-1? Well, I'm going to tell you right now that, yeah, you're in luck. We'll get Winston. Winston loved the Ecto-1. He is the guy who drives that car. He is awesome. Love me some Winston. And then in the passenger seat, we'll have old Ray sitting there detailing where to go with the job. If only one thing. I wish they could have made this a four-seater, you know, if they changed it somehow. But I'm glad that, yeah, it's the old one. Peter in the gunner seat, of course. And Egon, he's going to be flying Ecto-2. So, because, you know, he needs to be up in the air. We're fighting some kind of random ghost like Mikraw or whatever. But, yeah, you get to see the size difference. It's really cool to see. Nothing's changed. Some things have changed. But, really, it's pure 80s, baby. Don't even get me started on this one, though, in terms of fitting anything in that, right? Here is the Extreme Ghostbusters Ecto-1, and largely like the original Ecto-1 next to this one, same thing. You know, it's just the differences between the shows is really all it is. Heck, we even got Highway Haunter, Janine, Melnitz, and Louis Tully taking it out for a drive, and then boom, you know what happens. Turns into a monster. Everything in the real Ghostbusters gets haunted or turns into a monster or a ghost or whatever we're calling it these days. But yeah, this is cool. So I'll show you how the capture claw mechanism works. So you're fighting a ghost. Ghost trap's not working, right? Egon's been hard at work in his Egon's lab, which you should totally make and reissue, right? You should do that, Hasbro Kenner, if you're listening. But yeah, you basically pull this claw out. You got to make sure that the exhaust is in the right place. Then you simply slip the claw around the ghost. Because why not? Maybe it's some kind of ghost trap claw, you know what I mean? Reset the exhaust right there so that it turns into the locking mechanism so that when you drive the car, it will then catch and pull the string, which pulls the ghost into the car. It's the same thing as when I was a kid. You just kind of have to make it work. But yeah, once you get it going, it'll pull the ghost right in. And boom, capture mode. And you got him in the trap or something or whatever. And then, hey, you got to drive to the firehouse. And we got to make sure that this Ecto-1 fits within the confines of the firehouse. But as many of us know, the Ecto-1 never really fits perfectly in there. But we'll see. We know what's up. So you just kind of fit it back in there, get it to where it rolls over the ramp, and close the doors. And you got yourself an Ecto-1 that fits inside the very old firehouse. And yeah, they got there just in time because Dr. McCatheter or something, yeah, he's waiting for him. And all the ghosts are having a party in the firehouse. This is a lot of fun. These are basically three new real Ghostbuster toys. There's just enough difference between the old ones to the new ones. And hey, check it out. I'm going to pat myself on the back here because I flattened out the stickers and applied them all on my lonesome and it came out great. Even the back windshield, right? Got it going really, really nicely. So very happy that I was able to do that. Ecto-1, you got the Ghostbusters insignia all over this thing. It's beautiful. Man, oh man, they really knocked it out of the park. So hands down, well done for doing reissues, recreation, everything else. They did a fantastic job down to the little Ecto-1 ghost. I think in terms of collectors that are worried that, oh no, we're going to get confused with the old ones, the new ones. The years are all over this, 2021. You're not going to get confused. There's a lot of differences between them. The Ecto-1, a little bit more subtle than the ghosts, we'll just say. But yeah, if you know, you're definitely going to see this. Ecto-1 is a lot more brand new. We'll just say that. Now, these should start hitting Walmart stores very, very soon. They are a Walmart store exclusive. And, you know, Father's Day is coming up. Maybe just in time. Hopefully they hit stores. might make for a great gift for dear old dad. Let him know that you know that, yeah, he's a nerd. But I am curious to know what you guys think about these new real Ghostbuster figures. Will you be grabbing them? Comment below. Let me know. Let's talk everything real Ghostbusters. And thank you again to Hasbro for sending these over to me to give you guys this fresh look. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you ever have any questions about real Ghostbusters, do not hesitate to hit me up in the comments, email me, what have you. Check me out on Instagram, Toy Shiz, all that jazz. And I'm going to leave you guys with that. As always, drink some great coffee, eat some great food. But most importantly, remember, when it comes to old real Ghostbusters toys, you can't ever top the Kenner ones. But dagnabbit, yeah, these come pretty close. And when you do, let me know what you found. I'll talk to you guys soon. Adios.